Welcome to another tutorial. In this Blender, we're going to be looking at moving and repositioning and resizing your foregrounds of your chroma keys. In this, we're in Blender 2.69, although 2.71 or 7.2 will be fine. It does exactly the same thing. Let's quickly set up, going to the movie clip editor, opening a video that we're going to be looking at, and we have one already. We have done 92 frames here, scrolling the middle mouse button, and you've got that. We are 92 frames in the sequence, and so we're set up. Let's go to the node editor, set up a basic chroma by activating first your node editor, then use nodes button and your backdrop. Tick that. Render layers, we don't need that. Node, add an input of a movie clip to see the movie that we have just done. Select it there in the drop down menu, and there it appears. To see it on the backdrop, we're going to add an output viewer and put it over here, and the composite also. If we connect the output of the image into the viewer, we can see in the backdrop, and the V key will allow us to zoom out. To see it as a final output, we can close that panel, drag that across and down to then reassign this window to the UV image editor, and connecting the movie clip to the composite node and making sure that's at 100% resolution and that we also have 29.97 frames per second, because that's what we're working in. Push the render button and it will render the final output. Scrolling with the middle mouse button, you'll be able to see that as our final output. The backdrop here is not always the same as the final output. This is the final output. So to do our key, we're going to now add a matte key and position it up here somewhere. Click the key color, get the dropper, select the blue color, which is there. Connect our image into the image, and to check our matte, to clean it up, we're going to take the matte or our alpha channel and feed it into the viewer, and we get a black and white representation of it. The black being transparent, white being opaque, so that means we have a little bit of rubbish here and here that we want to get rid of. The rest of the key has been redone, has done before, and is fairly reasonable. I won't need to do anything with the parameters there. So let's go back to the movie clip editor and then make a key to get rid of that rubbish. The tracking by default, we can then change that to mask mode and then create a new one, and it's called mask. We don't have to rename it. We now control left click to make our points to make our mask around, and alt C to close it. If the character was to move, I could animate that, but I'm sure he's not going to move anywhere in this shot, so I'll just leave it static like that. Going back to the node editor, we can then add an input mask, select the mask that we have just done, because there might be more than one there that you've done, connect it to the viewer, and you can see representation of the mask. There's our mask, and that is transparent around it. So we can now add a color mix node to take advantage and use it by connecting the picture of that key, making sure our alpha channel is activated, and take it down to the viewer node, and there we have our basic key with a white background. If I now take that mask and put it into the factor button, it will use the mask and cut out all of that junk that was there. That's what it's cutting out. It's just showing this portion of it and cutting out that junk. So now it's a nice clean white background. We can now add an input of an image. So we're going to open up a image editing program, something like GIMP. And here's our picture. We need to get rid of some of the modern trappings around the place. I'll put it in the countryside in the back there, add a little bit of gardens to one side of it and some grass to the front of it. Then we're going to export it so we can use it in Blender. And it looks like we have one here, which we can then connect into the background, which is the top button there. And there we have it on the backdrop, but not in our final output. So connect the mixer to the composite, and then we have the final output, the final size. As you can see, the background picture is larger than the actual output size. Here is the output. Now, if we were to have our foreground the right size and shape that we want for our key, and the background all fine, we are fine. But what happens if we want to resize our foreground and put him somewhere, or the background for that matter? We can do that by using Add Distort Transform. Now, a transform node is a good node to move things around. Nearest is the lowest accuracy, bicubic is the highest accuracy in placement. We have where to put an image into. For example, here if we put an image in and then output it, for example, back into that mix node, and nothing happens because all the parameters have not changed. If I was to click and drag those across, it will move the character according to those number of pixels. I can also just click, select, and then type in a number, enter, and that will also be another way of more accurate. And if I go negative 100, I can also do the same. I can also change the angle of it by this angle here, but the computer doesn't like that at the moment, so let's do that. Now, scale, we can also do the same. We can make him 0.2 scale, for example, and shrink him down. Now, you'll notice that this big shape around here is not shrinking with our character that we're shrinking. Let's change the background just into something a little bit more zoomed in on the backdrop by adding this, which we have done before. Okay, now you'll notice the mask has not changed size nor position the same as the foreground key has. So we needed to copy that by Control Copy and then Control V, and it will paste another copy. Of that transform node, and now we can place it onto the mask. So now we have our smaller image and also our mask shrunk down. But every time we go and shift the character, we will now have to change the other one as well by Control Copy, Control V, Enter, and that will be okay. So let us move him around to maybe negative 200. Right, I have more or less where I want him to be, and now I would like to just trim off the bottom of his in there. So let's go back to the movie clip editor and make a new mask and call it window. And I'm going to not do it on him. I want a picture of the background, which I can do by clip open clip and importing that movie clip. But it will be a one-framed movie clip of that very picture. If I go forward, I will get nothing, but because there are no frames there. But if I go back to frame one, it will show me exactly where we are. So now I can do my mask by Control left click and very quickly make a Alt C to close that. And then just tidy it up a little bit, and to put some feathering on it, I can on a point I can to shift, drag that out, and I now have some feathering on my mask. So I can go back to the node editor and apply that mask to him. Now I will need a mask to go into a fact button, so I will need another mix node by add color mix, or I can just copy and paste one of the other mixers and connect the compositor up again, making sure that I have the alpha channel activated. And here we have our output from here as the image with a white background underneath it. So now if I add an input mask and select the mask we just did of the window and connect it to the factor button, it will now cut out everything and let the background show through there's that here. Now if we want the background to be not white, we can take the image and plug, or the background image, and plug it into the bottom, and it will put it behind that piece that we've cut out. Now that's okay if he is now on the outside of the window with him nicely trimmed across the bottom there, but we need the window on top of him. Now this gets a little complicated, but we can do it okay. What we need to do is to get another mix node, either copy and paste one there, or just get one from the mix there, put it on the bottom, and then put the background image on top of it in the bottom button. We now have our output from here with the puppet outside the window plus the background image on top of it. If we now use this factor button to reduce the transparency, we go like 0.5, we should be able to get some transparency of the window on top of, maybe 0.6, on top of the puppet. But that is all there. Now we need to put the bars on top of that without transparency. So we need to go back to the movie clip editor and create a new mask and call this one window bars, and then create, using control click, the mask, alt C to close it. Now to make a multi-piece mask, we can then take this and then push the A key to deselect it. Then I can make another one. Let's see. And then I'll just pause the capture while I go through that, the multi-piece mask done. And if you A deselects, A selects again, but this white one is selected of all the pieces. I can now hold the Alt key down and from a point drag that out to give me some transparency. Right click on the next one to activate it, Alt, then drag out for some feathering, should I say. So we can give each one of those some feathering so that the borders are not too sharp when they get superimposed on the puppet. And each one of those points can be individually dragged to the feathering that you want. So let's go back to the node editor and then add in another mixer by add color mix. Place it in the line And this time, instead of using the transparency like the glass was transparent, we're just going to do a straight add input mask to then select the window bars that we have just done, put it into the factor button, making sure that the alpha button is activated, and there that is the window that we've got. And we're going to, we have now the puppet from this system here with the window put on top with some transparency, feeding that into the another copy of windows with the bars masked to go on top of that, and there we have our output. Now, just to make sure that if there was a situation where there is some movement around the rest of the picture apart from that window, then I would really only want this piece of window on top. So I'm going to just add another color mix node and place it up here. Take the output of what we've just done now, activating the alpha, connecting it to our outputs, and then I'm going to use another add input mask and select just the window, not the window bars. Connect that into the factor, and with this white will tell me, so that is now everything else is trimmed around it. Now if I had a movie of something happening with that, instead of an image it would be a movie, in which case that would be good. But I'm just going to now take the image again, sort of insurance, just in case I want to do anything else in that area. And there we have it. So that's our final node setup for our final image of him behind the window. It's two layers there. I'm going to export it now by a PNG sequence with compression 100%, go to the place where we want and create a new folder, call it something, go into it and then call the sequence something, and then accept that, and then push animate, and now it will now render off the sequence of that video with the puppet behind the window inside that building.